Bonjour à tous. Good morning, everyone. Buenos días a todos. Dear participants, on behalf of the experts in international trade at the Chamber of Commerce of Metropolitan Montreal, we welcome you to our webinar of the International Meeting Series. Today's topic is Jalisco, Mexico's hub and Silicon Valley of Latin America. I would like to thank the Economic Development Agency of Canada for the regions of Quebec for its ongoing support of World Trade Center's Montreal's activities who made this webinar possible. My name is Camille Crozier, and I'm Project Manager for International Market Development at the Chamber of Commerce of Metropolitan Montreal. I have the honor to introduce our main speakers today, Sergio Rios. Sergio is Foreign Investment General Director for Jalisco Economic Development Ministry. He worked at the Foreign Trade Bank of Mexico, Bancomex, as a Senior Trade Commissioner. From 2008 to 2010, he was Vice President for Government Relations at Great Panther Silver in Guanajuato, Mexico. From 2010 to 2018, he was Regional Director at ProMexico, the Mexican Trade Promotional Organization in charge of 7 states. Before we start, I just want to make a moment to say that this event will be entirely in English. Veuillez prendre note que ce webinaire est entièrement en anglais. Toutefois, si vous avez des questions à la fin, il me fera un plaisir de les traduire. Antes de empezar, quiero decirles que el evento de hoy será totalmente en inglés. Sin embargo, si tiene algunas preguntas al final, las traduciré sin problema. Please take a moment to look at the platform. If you have any questions, please write them in the designated Q&A box located on the bottom center of your screen, and we'll address them towards the end of the webinar. You may ask your questions in the official language of your choosing, and I'll be happy to translate for you if needed. If you would like to watch this webinar again, we'll make the recording available on the Chamber of Commerce of Metropolitan Montreal website, as well as our YouTube page. Once again, welcome everyone, and Sergio, you now have the floor.
Thank you, Camille. Thank you very much to everybody to stay here today. Bonjour, good morning, buenos dias. And I am very happy to receive this invitation to present Jalisco. I would say that if you don't know anything about Jalisco, I think if you like tequila, if you like the Mexican music, basically, you know Jalisco. Why? Because Jalisco has all the icons of Mexico. Then welcome to Jalisco, and I'm going to present exactly what we are doing here in the state and how you can take these opportunities that we see right now, especially with the new USMCA that we have seen that a lot of companies from Canada and USA are very interested to check how they can take advantage of this. As I mentioned to you, Jalisco is located on the west coast of Mexico. We are basically in the same sites as BC, Washington, Oregon, California, and then is Jalisco in the middle of Mexico. Jalisco is well known for 2 cities. One city is Guadalajara, of course, and the other one is a very famous tourist destination called Puerto Vallarta that I'm quite sure that many Canadians from Montreal, they take advantage of our fantastic winter that we can have in Puerto Vallarta on the beach. Then that's Jalisco, and then you can see where we are located in America. Now, many times they ask me, where is the most of the industry located in Jalisco? We have something that we call the Guadalajara metropolitan area. And Guadalajara metropolitan area, we have more than 5 million inhabitants there. You can see the different municipalities that integrate this metro area. And when you land, let's say the airport is in the Tlajomulco one and the south one, and you said, I am in Guadalajara, you say in Guadalajara, because all this metro area, we call it Guadalajara, even that is integrated by the 9 different municipalities that, as I said, is where most of the industry in Jalisco is located. Now, we have been doing very well. I think if you see the statistics and you see the competitive analysis that they have done, Jalisco is ranking between number 2 and 3. We have been growing very well, 7% this year. Even that Mexico is decreasing, Jalisco keep growing. Exports are booming, especially you know that we are very well known for many products that we export worldwide. And in direct foreign investment, last year we were third place, and this year we are fourth place so far up to this September. Something that I would like to highlight in foreign direct investment is that many of the investment are from companies that they are already in Jalisco and they are expanding their operations. That means that they are pleased and happy what is happening here in the state, and they are expanding the operations that they have right now. And more or less 60%, they are expanding operation, and 40%, they will be related with new investment that are coming. Then I think this is good indicators for our economy. Now, why Jalisco is so important? Because you know that Jalisco is between the second and third most important city after Mexico City, that Mexico City is integrated by Mexico City and the State of Mexico. These are our strengths. One is demography. Demography, why? Because many, let's say, people from other states, they would like to live in Jalisco, they would like to work in Jalisco, and I think that's something very important. I'm going to mention to you that we have been focused in technical careers because we know that it's important for the new industry that they are coming to the States. Talking about high-tech exports, around 60% of our exports are related with high-tech. I mentioned that we have very famous tourist destinations as Puerto Vallarta, as a tequila town, and also the Chapala Lake. You know that the Chapala Lake is only 40 minutes away from the airport, and we have a huge Canadian community living in Chapala Lake. Productivity, we have a very high productivity. We are an export-driven state, and we are very attractive for foreign investment and young population that is coming, studying, and working here in the state. We have one strategy called Red Jalisco, meaning that for the middle of 2022, every single municipality in the state is going to have high-speed internet. We believe that if we want, let's say, to increase and to have the competitiveness that we have right now, we have to continue in this path, and to continue in this path, everybody has to have access to high-speed internet. Now, this is very important for everybody. Other states in Mexico, they are focusing one or two industrial areas. We have 22 industrial areas, 19 of them, they are export driven. Then you can see that we start from IT services, that is going to be one of the main focus of this talk, from software engineering, software development, and shared services, BPO, KPO. Really, we are very strong, but also we are very strong in manufacturing. Then if you are planning to have any type of business possibilities, you can see that we have automotive, aerospace, medical devices, furniture, many, many industries, and we can find, let's say, the right solution when you want to come to Jalisco. And of course, we have agro-food and beverage. We provide to Mexico 12% of this sector. Basically, 12% of the agri-food in Mexico is produced and made in Jalisco. We are very strong in dairy. We are number one in confectionery, and of course, we are number one in agave and tequila. And I make the difference between agave and tequila because also you know that we have agave syrup that now is very popular everywhere. We work together with the different chambers of commerce and association. You can see here some examples, and we are in contact with them. Then when you are planning to do business in Jalisco, we will have meetings, we will have reunions with these chambers of commerce in order for you to know more, let's say, deeply about the industry and about the business possibilities that you can find in Jalisco. Talking about international trade, and I think this is very important and it's going to be related also with the topic about logistics that I would like to talk this morning, is we export 972 different products. And you say, why that number is relevant? Because we are the number one state with more diversification in our export products. The state that follows us, they only export 500, but we do 992, and we reach 181 different destinations, meaning that we only need 11 more countries, and then we will have a coverage basically worldwide. Then this is to focus how international Jalisco is in international trade. Now, what are our main exports? And you can see there, we have automotive industry, we have high tech, electric, but I would like to highlight something. 15% of a Tesla is made in Jalisco. That means that we are merging automotive industry and high tech industry. 30% of the new EV Homer is going to be made in Jalisco. Then if you see, Jalisco is very up to date of what's going on. And we know that the EV industry is going to be very important for the next year. And we are working on that, and companies are providing the right products, the right services to take advantage of the EV industry. Now, who are our main investors? Around, let's say 45% of our investment is coming from United States and Canada, and 40% is coming from the European Union. Those will be, they will make more or less 85%. But there are very important players. Japan is a very important player here in Jalisco with good, let's say, facilities from companies from Japan. India, we are the number one recipient of Indian investment all over Mexico. And China start to become a very important player. I'm going to explain later on why China start to look very carefully at Jalisco as a strategic partner. Now, this is a snapshot of some of the companies that they are located in Jalisco. You can see companies from China, Japan, Italy, France, UK, from many, many, many nationalities. That means that Jalisco is open, let's say, to receive companies from everywhere, and the companies are growing, the companies are happy, and the companies want to continue to do business with Jalisco State. Now, let me talk about talent and innovation, especially because if we are going to talk why Jalisco is considered the Silicon Valley of Mexico, Latin America, I think we have to focus in talent and innovation. First of all, we have a very strong, let's say, schooling system. I know very well the Canadian system because I lived there for 8 years, but we have also a very strong school system with very world-class universities, with a business school. If you see international school, we have the American, the German, the Canadian, the French, and the Japanese schools, especially for those expats that they want to come here and they want to have their kids in their own, let's say, system. Then we have 5 international schools. We have major business school, technological schools, and we are the number one state with more job training centers. Why? Because many companies need to train their employees, the personnel, in certain type of things, and you can find it here in Jalisco. Now, we are very important created new talent. We graduate 16,500 engineers per year, and 7,500 engineers, they are specializing high tech. Then if you see, we are working private universities, technological schools, public universities, in order to have the right human resources for the type of business that you want to develop in Jalisco. There are other states in Mexico that maybe they are very appealing, but they don't have this number of engineers and technicians in the state. And if you see also in this chart, Jalisco provides 7% of the ITC engineers in Mexico. If you go to any other state, you will find engineers that they study in Jalisco, or you will find, let's say, people from Jalisco working in other states. And something that is very important is Jalisco has the first ministry of innovation, science, and technology. This ministry has 16 technical institutes. And these technical institutes, they can adapt the curricula according with the needs of the new investors that are coming to the state. Then if you need to have certain type of expertise, we can go with these 16 technical institutes, and these institutes will adapt the curricula in order for you to have the right people for the right type of project that you want to develop in the state. Now, in the past 10 years, something amazing has happened in Jalisco. More and more companies are opening R&D centers. That meaning, because sometimes we believe that you come to Mexico because it's a cheap labor, but now, you have a lot of people, you know, that they are working in these R&D centers. For instance, Continental has a huge R&D center, and it cannot grow more, because if we grow more this R&D center here in Jalisco, it will be bigger than the one that they have in Germany. Intel has a R&D center with around 1,200. Oracle has a R&D center with 1,600 employees. Bosch, NXP, that you know that is a Dutch company, also doing a semiconductor, has an R&D center. Hella moved the headquarters from Mexico City to Guadalajara. Why? Because they believe that they can grow more here. Bayer, that you know that is a German company. And Plexus, that they are doing medical devices, especially, they have an R&D center here. The other ones that you see on the bottom, they are not, let's say, private R&D center. They are public. They are from the government, but they are also here in Jalisco. Then this is a very important, let's say, chart, because you can see that not only, let's say, the labor is important, also what I call the intellectuality of the people here in Jalisco is very significant. Talking about, let's say, the schooling system, we have something that we call innovation model. We try to educate primary, secondary, high school, university, according with the needs of the companies that they are coming to the state. Then we are, teaching coding, we are teaching some techniques that we know that they are going to require for the next future. Now, according with Education First, they make a study about Mexico, and they found that Jalisco is the number one state with more bilingual people. And we have been proving with the companies that they are here, because most of the companies, they found that that's true, that you can find bilingual people for many, many different activities and many different, let's say, possibilities that you want to develop in the state. As everywhere in the world, you know, startups start booming, entrepreneurship is booming, innovation and technology is booming. Then if you can see, here is more or less how is our innovation culture here in Jalisco. And you can see who are the first steps, that is basically the University of Guadalajara together with Stanford. And they have the Fab Lab here of Latin America in high school. But something that I would like to highlight is the communities. Some of the names of the communities here, you can see that they are based basically in Silicon Valley. And now they are here in Jalisco, like Meet Trooper, Hackers and Founders, Hacker Garage. Then they have found that entrepreneurship is very important. And why is important? Because many of the people who work in the big companies, now they start their own business. And this is like a spin-off that they have made, and they need support from these communities. In Triggers, you can see that we have different events that I invite to come. One of those events that they are very interesting. And the most important event that we have is Talentland. Talentland is the biggest entrepreneurship event with more or less 45,000 participants. This year and last year was virtual. We are hoping 2022 we will do it again. But the companies, they can participate as a keynotes, like a panels, hackathons, or also for recruitment talent. Now, let's talk about logistics. I think logistics is very important, and especially for the companies that are attending this webinar. We understand that many companies come to Jalisco for what we call nearshoring. We know that now with the USMCA, they want to call it no-shoring, meaning to be the closest possible to your customer. Then, as I said, Jalisco is a good place because basically it's very easy to reach and to fly to Canada, to the United States, even to Central and South America, as we are going to see. We are very well positioned, and we have a logistics system. You can see here all the corridors, how we can reach, let's say, at least six different states around Mexico. We have a company that is closing down the distribution centers, a small distribution center all around the central part of Mexico, and they are building a big distribution center here in metro area. And they said, from this distribution center in the metro area of Guadalajara, I can reach 70% of the population in Mexico. Then if you see location and what we have done in infrastructure for logistics and moving goods from one place to another place has been important for us and for the companies that they are coming. Of course, we have a very good railroad system. You can reach basically any border in the state, you can see that we can go to Nogales, or we can go to El Paso, Texas, and we can go to Laredo. Then the railroad system is good. The road system is also good. We can move very easy. And I mentioned that China start to see the business possibilities of establishing operations here in Jalisco. Why? Because we are very close to a seaport called Manzanillo. Manzanillo is not Jalisco, it's Colima State, but we are the, let's say, the biggest state very close to Manzanillo. And 90% of the imports coming from Asia enter through Manzanillo. Then the companies, they said, we want to be in the closest state where we can have a manufacturing or a factory close to there. Then we are only 2 hours and a half away from Manzanillo. And many companies, especially Chinese, are taking advantage of this closeness that we have with Manzanillo Seaport. And Manzanillo is like one of our partners to do this type of things. Even, for instance, there are things that are happening that is very interesting. Shipping companies from South America, they are entering through Manzanillo, and they are taking advantage of the International Airport of Guadalajara that we are going to see in a few minutes. How important is our air cargo facility that we have here in Jalisco? Now, Manzanillo Seaport, these are the connections that you see. We have connection with South America, we have connections with North America, and of course, we have a very, very strong connection with everything related with Asia. Then that's why Manzanillo is so important for that. Now, I would like to highlight that for 2024-2026, we are going to have the number one airport in Mexico, concentrated only in one spot. We are going to move from moving 15 million passengers to move 30 million passengers. You can see all the details of this expansion. The first part of this expansion will be ready next year, 2022. The second phase will be ready 2024. And the complete expansion of the airport is going to be 2026. Many companies are seeing this. Why? Because it's easy for them to move. In a week time, we are going to have direct flight from Guadalajara to Madrid 3 times a week. And we are seeing that the other European airline companies want to establish this type of routes from Jalisco to Europe. We have the number 3rd airport and number 5 airport. 3rd is Guadalajara, 5 is Puerto Vallarta. Who are number 1 and 2? Number 1 is Mexico City, number 2 is Cancun, but number 3 is Guadalajara. But with this expansion, as I mentioned before, we are going to be number 1. You can see some direct flights that you can find from Guadalajara up to United States and also to Central and South America. Now, this is also very, very important. We are improving our air cargo facilities. Now we have more or less 10 weekly frequencies. We are number 1 in volume, number 2 in international operations. With expansion of the airport, we are going to be number 1 in everything. And you can see how many frequencies we have to the US and Canada. Air Canada is a newcomer to us. Then to Asia, for instance, Atlas Cargo is flying from Shanghai to Guadalajara. You can see other air cargo lines that go to Seoul, Korea, Hong Kong. Then this hub that is happening in the airport is very important, and I will give you some examples. Here is, for instance, the WTC that is in the airport that is basically working to try to be more efficient and to move goods everywhere. You can see here part of the operations, and they work with the main industry that you can see in the right-hand side at the bottom. Now, also through the airport, you can see that we are working with different strategic business models from platforms, from fulfillment, courier, and custom agencies, and try to be very, very efficient. Let me give you two examples. You see Amazon and Mercado Libre. Amazon is expanding the distribution center here in Guadalajara, especially for this reason. Mercado Libre is also expanding their operation here in Guadalajara because they found it like that. Then I think it's a big possibility for companies that they are, especially in this new area of the e-commerce, to take advantage of what is happening here in Jalisco. Here is the top five in e-commerce and top three in global m-commerce. And you can see that in e-commerce, Mexico ranks in number five, and in m-commerce, Mexico ranking number three. Then we see that really this new trend that happened through the pandemic, let's say it's helping. It's helping to get this culture of moving goods and buying goods. And here we can see more or less how WTC at the airport, they can do many activities and what are they doing. Of course, they are working in the agri-sector or agri-industry. Some of the clients, you can see Driscoll that is very well known in North America for the berries and blueberries and all those kind of things. But we are working in the agri-food sector very successfully. Also, the pharmaceutical industry is very important, and you can see some names like Fresenius or like PISA, that is a local one, and how the operations are moving through the international airport of Guadalajara in order to have the right products at the right time in the pharmaceutical industry. Automotive, that's another one. Automotive, if you know, the new automotive hub in Mexico is not longer in the border with the United States. Is more in the central part of Mexico than the main airport that these automotive companies are using to ship the goods to other places is the International Airport of Guadalajara, and you can see in this chart. Of course, parcel delivery that UPS also is using the facility that we have in logistics, and exports in electronics. Electronics, you know, companies like Cisco, like Motorola, like IBM, They are using these facilities in order to get on time to different places. They use, of course, as I mentioned before, Cathay Pacific, or they use Cargolux, or all those companies that they are operating from Jalisco. Now, this is our proposal for the next year that is going to happen with what we call the Airport Logistic Hub. You see that basically in the round part, that's going to be the expansion of the airport. We are going to have an extra space for the airport, but there are many business possibilities that we want to develop around the airport. We are going to develop a new exhibition center, an innovation cluster. It's going to be, of course, some housing, universities, a shopping mall. But at the end, what we want to do is to push the south of the city in order to have this new, as I said, logistic hub that we are going to do in the next year here in Jalisco. And this is something that maybe you will be interested in knowing more, and I will be more than happy. At the end, you will have more details. And if you are interested in knowing more about this type of projects, I will be more than pleased and happy to help you. Of course, if you are planning to come here, we have the different type of infrastructure from industrial parks to tech districts. That's something that is very interesting. Now we have two very consolidated tech districts where most of the ITC companies and high-tech companies are located. We have one software center, and we have also another facilities here in the state. Now, talking about quality of life, talking about quality of life. I know that many of you have been here in Jalisco. Our winter today, in comparison with Montreal, is around 27 degrees. Of course, you know that we have the seaside of Manzanillo or Puerto Vallarta very close by. We have the mountains with, let's say, Tapalpa, and we have also the lake. Then really quality of life is very pleasant. And that's why many companies, when they establish here in Jalisco and they want to attract talent from other states, they will do it because they found that Jalisco is a very good place to live, to raise a family. They have a very good school system, everything. And of course, if you are thinking about industrial areas, we have industrial areas spread all over the metropolitan area. And depending what is your market, whether you want to be, these industrial areas are. Also, something that is interesting is if you are going to have expats, we have different residential areas. Because sometimes companies are worried about the expats. And as I said, the expat, they can find different places to live, especially if they are single, if they are married, if they have kids, if they have a dog, whatsoever, you can find it here. Now, let me enter to business opportunities that I think is important. The business opportunities that we are pursuing in Jalisco, one is high tech. Why high tech? Because we believe that software development, hardware, IoT, VR, machine learning, cybersecurity, those companies are coming here. Cloud computing are coming here. Then we see that basically we are not in the basics. We are more than in the basic trying to attract this investment. Pharmaceutical and medical devices are very, very important also here in the state, especially with the pandemic. Aerobusiness. We don't make helicopters or planes, but we make the technology for the helicopters and plane. Of course, we are talking about metal mechanic and automotive. EV is very important for us, for what I mentioned to you regarding Tesla and the EV Homer, and of course, renewable energies. Now, you wonder why Jalisco is so important in the high-tech ecosystem. Why Jalisco sometimes is well known as the Silicon Valley of Mexico? Well, this is the story that we have. We started basically 60 years ago. The first company that arrived to Jalisco was Siemens in 1962. Then you see other names that probably they don't longer exist as they were, like Burroughs, Motorola, Kodak, and then IBM. And you see other names that start to, let's say, to come to the state and to try to see what they can do and try to work with universities, try to work with the government, and is how we create this strong ecosystem. Now, in the electronic side, seven of the 10 most important contract manufacturers are located in Jalisco. You can see some of the names that they are very well known, like Foxconn, like UC, like Flex, like Sanmina, and seven of them, they are here and growing. That's very important and growing. They haven't been, let's say, in the same size that they are, right? They basically growing, trying to look for new opportunities, bringing new projects to Jalisco. And why they are bringing these projects to Jalisco? Basically, because they found that this, let's say, very interesting, all the knowledge, everything what is happening in this amazing industry of the electronic industry. This industry has more or less 6,000 employees, and there are around more than 100 electronic companies here, and all the suppliers that they are developing and all the suppliers that they are, let's say, trying to put in the supply chain is very important. I am very happy because right now I am working with two Canadian companies that they want to enter exactly this market. And I explained to them, I think Jalisco is the best location that you can have, especially for this electronic ecosystem that you can find and with all the suppliers that you can have. And this is a very, very important chart of this presentation. This is our strong ecosystem. You can see on the top 500 companies, you can see some of the names, companies from Continental, Microsoft, Dell. You can have EMS, as we saw it, some of the contract manufacturers that you can find here, IT companies, BPOs, design companies, creative industries, and at the bottom, you can see high-tech SMEs companies. And those SMEs, they are spin-offs. The owners of these companies, they used to work in the companies that they are above. Now they have their own company and they are suppliers and they are spin-off. They are doing many, many things. Then this is a very interesting ecosystem if you want to come here. And as I say, sometimes company come, let's say, with an automotive project, but at the end they decided to have an R&D here or to try to do software development or to try to do something different. Then I think is very important. On the left-hand side, you can see that now we have venture capital, especially many, many names of venture capital have been established here in Jalisco. We have incubators and accelerators also located here. And on the right-hand side, you see the universities and all the supporting organizations. That's important. When you say why this ecosystem is so strong, because we have a lot of supporting organizations. IJALTI, CANIETI, many of those organizations and other states, they didn't have it. We have it. And that's why we try to push and to grow basically this fantastic industry that we call the ecosystem. More than 1,000 high-tech companies, 300 startups, researchers, we have a lot. We have more than 150 high-tech jobs, and we have students. And you see the annual rate that we are growing. We are growing 20% is our annual rate. Then, as I said, if you decided to make your mind where in Mexico you have been located in this industry, is Jalisco. You said, oh, no, because there is a lot of competition. Competition is good and it's very friendly. What we want to do is a strong ecosystem for everybody. Now, let me go very deep, very simple. with other key industries that you may be interested, because I know the diversity of Canada, and I would like to also express where are other opportunities. In the automotive industry, there are opportunities. We provide 3.5% of the national production of auto parts, so that's important. We these are some of the names of the main automotive companies that they are located here. And it's important to know that we are one of the main exporters of aftermarket products to Central and South America. We know that in Canada, in the United States, many has the possibility to have a brand new car, but Central and South America, sometimes they need to have, let's say, replacement. And we are very strong exporting aftermarket products. We have other companies in the metal mechanic industry, because that's a question that sometimes, let's say, electronic companies ask me, do you have a die casting? Do you have molding? Do you have foundry? Yes, we have it. You see some of the names here located, and the companies, they say they are providing to other industries what you need in the metal mechanic industry. Also, suppliers of engineered plastic injection harnesses or industrial packing, you can see here. Then, as I said, I put the logos because I want you to see how Jalisco can support your business. Even if you are in the high tech, in the electronic, or you are in another industry, we have the possibility to support you, to have the right suppliers, to try to make your project smooth when you come here to Jalisco State. Now we have, as I mentioned to you, EV companies. We have identified around 200 suppliers that they are doing something for the EV industry. Some of them, they are doing software development. Other ones, they are doing electronics, plastic, metal mechanics. But the companies are, let's say, moving to this new trend that is called the EV industry, and that we are very excited about that, because I am a very firm believer that EV hybrid, it has to be the future, you know, everywhere. BPO, ITO, and KPO also has been growing. You can see companies from France. You can see companies from Brazil. You can see companies from the UK. They have established BPOs and KPOs here. And something that is amazing, for instance, you see AstraZeneca. And AstraZeneca started with 50 people working in the BPO of AstraZeneca here. Right now, AstraZeneca, from 50, they have 750 people. And all other companies there, they started very small with 50, 60, 100. And now they have, let's say, for instance, Teleperformance, that you know on the top, now they have almost 2,000 people working here in Jalisco, not only in the metropolitan area, also in other municipalities outside the metropolitan area. Then, as I said, this is another business possibility that could be very interesting. Aerobusiness, we have 46 companies. And as I said, most of them, they are doing software development, or they are doing some electronics, especially for the aerobusiness industry, that I know that especially Canada is very important. We have a very interesting case. He's a Canadian, and he has a company that is making drones. And I don't know why. I think maybe it's because he has a girlfriend here. He came here to Jalisco, and he started the company here in Jalisco. He has been growing very, very good, and he has a very good business right now, especially in the drones. Especially in some type of drones that he is developing here in the state. Medical devices, especially with the pandemic, we see that medical devices start booming. We have some global EMS like Sanmina, Flex, and Jabil that they are doing here, the electronics and some components. But also we have other companies, as you can see, like Plexus or Benchmark, that they are doing medical devices here in the state, or IT companies. And this is going to see something that we are seeing. We are seeing, for instance, many companies that they are doing telemedicine or teletherapy. And those companies, they have found a very fertile, let's say, soil to do business here in Jalisco State. Pharma, we are also very strong. We have, if you see, a very mix of between international companies and national companies, with some of the big names that you know, like Pisa, like OmniLife, like Sophia, that they are local companies here from Jalisco. And also you have international companies that they are located here. We have also cosmetic and personal care. And this is an industry that has been growing, especially with natural ingredients, with natural products. And we believe that this industry is going to be a very significant in the next future. Plastic and rubber. Plastic and rubber, I would like to highlight that we are we have the leadership nationally in Mexico with more companies in plastic and rubber. And why this is important? Because plastic and rubber is used in many industries. Then, as I said, what I'm trying to put here in this screen is that you have suppliers from many industries that they can participate, that they can be your suppliers, and they can make your project smooth here in Jalisco. We have textile, that is another industry that is moving. Textile is important, not in the basic one. We are more in the fashion one or on the, let's say, more advanced manufacturing in textile. Of course, the biggest event in Mexico regarding fashion is called Intermoda. And maybe many of you, they have visited. I think it's a very interesting event because it is not only textile. You can have jewelry, you can have footwear, you can have, there is what we call fashion. It includes jewelry, includes footwear, and includes textile and garments. And we try to create a whole concept through the different chambers of commerce that they organize this fantastic event called Intermoda that I will invite you. This is also another highlight that I'd say. Jalisco has the most important expo venue in Latin America that maybe you know that is Expo Guadalajara. Then use that excuse to come to Guadalajara. You can come to ANTAD if you are planning to sell to supermarkets or department store. You can come to Expo Pack if you are doing some packing material. You can come to Expo Furniture if you are doing some for furniture. And those big events now, they are taking place here in Guadalajara, and it's an opportunity to see the industry, to see the different companies, because not only you are going to find companies from Jalisco in this event, you basically will find companies for all Mexico, and in some cases also companies from Central, South America, and other places. Then Expo Guadalajara, they have a very strong, let's say, program that it could be very good for you. And this is the region when we have focused most of the textile industry, and you see more or less where it's located, that is in the north part of Mexico. And another industry that we are pursuing is renewable energies. Especially Jalisco is working in the state energy agency. It has a state energy plan. And we believe that little by little, despite of what happened at the federal level, Jalisco is going to be very well positioning in trying to convince some of the companies that they are already here and how they can expand their operation in renewable energies. With this, I will put you a picture on the right-hand side who has been here in Guadalajara. You can have downtown. And on the left-hand side, you have the modern Guadalajara. Because sometimes we have the idea of the traditional colonial site of Guadalajara, but now we are a very modern city. And I think sometimes we have to get rid of those misunderstandings. You can find a very friendly city. You can have a very modern city. You can have a city that is vibrant and a city that is open for your business. And something that is interesting is we are open to all type of business. We are open to listen your proposal, to help you. I was telling to the organizers of this event that we work very close with the Canadian consulate here in Guadalajara. We have a Canadian consulate here in Guadalajara. I get along very well with the consul general. I get very along with the trade commissioner in Mexico City. Then we work together in order to put Jalisco in the mind of all the Canadians. Any information that you need, you have here my name. My name is Sergio Rios. I am the general director for foreign investment at the Ministry of Economic Development of Jalisco. You have my email. You can send me an email and I will be more than happy to answer any questions. Later on, if you need to have a video chat, a video conference, a Zoom meeting, I will be happy to do it. I have so many meetings by Zoom right now, and I am pleased to do it. And of course, the only last word that I want to tell you is thank you. Welcome to Jalisco. I hope this presentation is interesting for you. I know that you will have a copy of this presentation for your record, as well as a very interesting video that you will see more about Jalisco, how we have, let's say, not only the business side on the video, you can see also the cultural side, the rural side, and another facility that you can find in Jalisco. I will stop here. to see if you have any type of questions that I would like to ask, and I will be more than happy to do it.
All right, so I want to say thank you, Sergio, for this presentation, and I would like to hear about participants' questions. Does anyone has anything to ask? If so, feel free to write your questions in the Q&A box. So let me check the Q&A. We have one question from Marie de Sousa. Do you provide visa for digital nomads?
Well, we don't provide visa because at the end Canadians they don't need visa to come to Mexico, but we know that we have a lot of let's say high tech nomads working especially for Puerto Vallarta or for Chapala, and of course we support that, and we know that companies are doing that facility, you know.
Thank you very much. We have another question in the Q&A, which is quite long. Just for Canadian companies interested in doing business in Jalisco. This is not a question. We have another one here. How do you see the business relationship between Jalisco and Canada?
Oh, always we see them very positive. Sometimes people believe that the most strong relationship between Mexico and Canada is mining, especially because we have a lot of mines everywhere in Mexico. But no, the relationship is very, very good. As I said, I think there are many small and medium-sized Canadian companies established here, not the big ones, and they have found a very interesting market. Then what we try to pursue, especially with this type of webinars, with this type of events, is to put Jalisco in the mind of the Canadians and to see how they can, let's say, see the possibilities here. And also, we know that Canada has a very focused industries everywhere. Then, for instance, we are going to have a Quebec delegation next week here in Jalisco. Yes, next week it will be the Quebec delegation here. And of course, we are going to talk about business opportunities between Quebec and Jalisco, because Quebec has a representative here, Alberta has a representative here, and of course, the Canadian consulate. But we see that there are many business opportunities in different sectors. That's why I mentioned also the sector of fashion, because I know especially Montreal and that area is very specific on fashion and in some type of, let's say, industry related with that. But as I said, we are open to listen any type of proposal that you would like to have, and we will try to answer any questions that you may have, specific or let's say not that specific, but I will say that.
So thank you, Sergio, for your answer. We have another question. Are there any specific industries where you would see business opportunities with the province of Quebec?
I could say that most of the time we receive business delegation with ITC projects, and they come from all over Canada. We see companies that they are coming from Ontario, companies that they are coming from Quebec, companies that they are coming from Alberta. And as I said, it depends, let's say, if you can say more specific and tell me what type of business you are thinking of, I think I could answer more clearly, but we see the opportunities are big. Most of the time, the delegations that they are coming from Canada to Jalisco are based in the high-tech industry.
Thank you very much, Sergio. We have more questions, which is great for us. So we have another one. We have Joël Trudeau, that he's in the field of edtech sector. Do you help make connections within your higher ed ecosystem?
Yes, exactly. That's one of our purpose, to try to make connections, to try to put in contact with the ecosystem. If you are very specific, let's say with e-health industry, we try to put you in contact. Let's say if you want to be with the Ministry of Health, or you want to be, we have a very strong, now we have two clusters. Here in Jalisco, we have the medical cluster that is very strong, and we have another one that is called the e-health cluster. The e-health cluster has established maybe 2-3 months ago and has been very active. And I think if you want to be in contact with the e-health cluster, we can do that apart from the medical devices that also is a strong, let's say, cluster that has been developed here in the state.
Thank you very much once again. We have another one. Can you please explain in more details how the drone industry acts in Jalisco and how's their reglementation?
Well, the thing is, this Canadian company here in Jalisco, they are making drones, especially for different purposes. One of the main purposes is agribusiness. You know that sometimes you have to be monitoring, let's say, how is the agribusiness. One of the main fields in the agribusiness is, of course, the agave growing. And then they have a special, let's say, this type of drones that they are monitoring if the fields need some water or they have too much sun and everything. And that's one of the particular fields that they are doing. And also the drone industry here, what it's doing is related with a fire in the forest. Also to try to take care or to try to visualize if there is going to be a danger in the forest, then they will do that in the drone.
Thank you once again. We have another question from Pascal Deschamps. Is there some company or a market in Jalisco for electric bike?
Yes. Yes, we have a lot of competition right now coming from Asia. Then the main commerce in electric bikes and electric motorcycles here are coming from Asia. Then there is a possibility, of course. The market is growing, especially because now most of the city, they have special bike paths, you know, to move around the city, especially the new millennials, they like to bike, sometimes in electric, not in electric. But yes, there is a possibility and it's an industry that is growing.
So another question we have from Jonathan, is there any opportunity of workforce mobility out Jalisco? His business field is construction and it's a big issue out there. So if so, are there any construction formation or training given in Jalisco?
Yes. Yes, we work that through the Chamber of Construction. There is a local chamber here, and we work with them. And especially the new president of that chamber is very open to establish talks with international entities or with international companies. And that's what I said. I will be more than happy to help you and to put you in contact with all those details that you are asking in these questions.
Thank you very much. We have another one. What are your main concerns for the future industrial development of Jalisco?
I think the main concerns that we could have, of course, is we need to create more talent development. I think we need more engineers and we need more, let's say, engineers and technicians. But we are having a good approach, especially we are working in something that maybe in Canada also is happening, that is called reconversion, meaning that people that they don't have tech background, we are giving some specific classes in order for them to code in or to have a basic knowledge in high tech. That has been very, very good, especially accountants, architects, some people that study, let's say, business administration, and now they want to move, no? And I think if we continue that field, we are going to increase the base of talent that we would like to have, because with all the companies that they are coming to Jalisco, that will be one of my concerns, to have the right talent for the right people for the amount of companies that they are looking to grow here in the state.
We have another question from Martin Michaud. He's a food industry and laboratory consultant. Are there any needs for support and project from Canadian experts in the Jalisco food industry?
Yes, we have created here in Jalisco. It's a brand new organization, very, 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 very brand new organization. It has more or less like a year of being created. That is the kind of the CFA that you have in Canada, the Canadian food. I don't know if it's called Canadian food industry of FDA. It's like the equivalent of the FDA in the state. It's a local one, and they are eager to receive any type of support, orientation, or cooperation. And as I said, it's a brand new, and the name is ACISA, something like that. And they have been for next, I don't know, maybe a year or less than a year, but yes, I can put you in contact with the director of them, and then you can start conversations with them to see exactly what's going on in the food industry, because it's this new organization that we have here in Jalisco State.
So we have another question. How has COVID-19 affected the Jalisco's economic development?
I would say that Jalisco did very well. I think we follow the rules. We take advantage. We knew what's going on and how was going to come the COVID. And we took some very strong measures before the federal government. Then so far, if you can see the statistics, Jalisco did very well. We're still doing very well. We have basically 4 lockdowns here. At the end, the supply chain didn't stop, but I think we did it in comparison with other states. We did pretty well, and you can see the results right now, what we are doing and what is the position that we have. We are not among the, let's say, the five most contagious states in Mexico. And I think so far so good, we did it well, because we took a lot of precautions. Even now we use face masks. Most of the people, they are vaccinated. Then I think so far so good, Jalisco is doing well, especially because we have Puerto Vallarta, that is an international destination with many foreigners are coming. Then we have to take care of them and we have to take care of ourselves.
All right, so thank you very much, Sergio, for your time today. We're now at the end of the questions period. You will all automatically be directed to a satisfaction survey as you leave the platform, which I invite you to please complete. And we will also make the video recording available on our website, on our YouTube channel in the next days. And I'll also send an email to everyone with Sergio's details and presentation. So thank you again, Sergio, for your excellent presentation. And on behalf of the Chamber of Commerce of Metropolitan Montreal, I would like to thank you for joining us today. It was a pleasure for me to be your host, and I wish you all a good day and hope to see you at our next events.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.